Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about Jeremy Collier. Jeremy Collier basically belonged to the Restoration Age, alright, and the period during which Jeremy Collier was present was from 1650 to 1726. A question was asked in 2015 net, where the question, you know, they asked was that in Jeremy Collier's 1698 pamphlet attacking the immorality and profaneness of the English stage, who among the following was a principal target? Alright, इन्होंने एक किताब लिखी थी Immorality and Profaneness of the English Stage करके in the year 1698. It was basically a pamphlet, okay, and इस pamphlet में इन्होंने कुछ writers को criticize किया है. So who among the following was the principal target? Principal target कौन था? The, you know, the various examples were given and the answer was John Van Brook. Okay, so basically Jeremy Collier was an English theatre critic, and in the history of English drama, Collier is known for his anti-theatrical attack on the comedy of the 1690s. इन्होंने basically अपने इस pamphlet में इन्होंने attack किया है the comedy of Restoration Age of 1690s. Alright, in his short view of the morality and profaneness of the English stage, the name of the book or the pamphlet that he had written, इसका नाम था Short View of the Immorality and Profaneness of Me. Alright, and which draws for its emanation mostly on the plays of William Congreve, John Van Brook and John Dryden. So, in writers ke baare mein inhone criticize kiya hai and sabse zyada attack inhone John Van Brook ke against hi kiya hai. Alright, Collier devotes nearly 300 pages to decry what he perceived as profanity and moral degeneration in the stage productions of the era. तो स्टेज प्रोडक्शन में जो खामियाँ थी उस ज़माने में उसके बारे में इन्होंने लिखा है. एंड ही अटैक्स ऑन द मोरालिटी ऑफ रेस्ट्रेशन थिएटर. ऑलराइट, तो अकॉर्डिंग टू हिम द प्लेज डिड नॉट हैव एनी मॉरल वैल्यूज अटैच टू इट. सो कॉलियर आर्ग्यूड दैट you know, a good play is the one which influences the people and teaches us something. You know, it should provide some moral instruction. It should have some content which is good for the society. It is morally, you know, good for us. But the, you know, the comedy plays of that period did not have that message attached to it. Now, these pamphlets began a pamphlet war. अब इन्होंने जो पैम्फलेट लिखा था इट क्रिएटेड अ काइंड ऑफ वॉर बिटवीन कोलियर एंड द अदर प्ले राइट्स लाइक जॉन वैन ब्रूक. तो वैन ब्रूक ने भी इनको, यू नो, ही अटैक्ड हिम बैक. मैनी ऑफ द प्ले राइट्स रिस्पोंडेड इक्वली विद वेहेमेंट अटैक्स बट सम वर सो डीपली अफेक्टेड दे विदड्रॉ फ्रॉम द थिएटर परमानेंटली और सब्सटैंशली चेंज द अप्रोच टू राइटिंग कॉमेडीज लाइक विलियम कॉन्ग्रीव. अब क्या हुआ था, इन्होंने कुछ राइटर्स के अगेंस्ट लिखा था एंड कुछ राइटर्स ने अटैक बैक भी किया इनको, बट देर वर सर्टेन राइटर्स लाइक विलियम कॉन्ग्रीव जिन्होंने कॉमेडी लिखना ही बंद कर दिया आफ्टर दिस अटैक. सो दिस वाज अ वेरी सीवियर काइंड ऑफ, यू नो, अटैक विच रियली हिंडर्ड देयर वर्क इन फ्यूचर. सो दिस वाज काइंड ऑफ thing that prevailed during that period of time. So he was a, you know, a well-known critic jis ke likhne pe itna asar hua that, you know, William Congreve actually stopped writing. Then Collier also published an early encyclopedia in 1701 jiska naam tha the Great Historical, Geographical and Poetical Dictionary. Okay, so I hope you have liked this video. I know it's a very short video, but now I'm going to discuss certain questions dealing with the NET JR, you know, the NET exam. So, you know, this will be very beneficial to you all because there are certain questions which are not discussed in detail, and I hope you have liked the video and you can give a thumbs up. Okay, have a good day. Bye-bye.